All right, this is another answer for the magazine about the length of this, of the nails. So if you see here, in fact, it's not the same when we have a stretch the finger or straight or bent. It may change slightly the action you have with the nail here. So my advice is that, as I mentioned before, just same like what Paco does, have it, keep it short. Actually, we should have a little bit less nail than the tip of the flesh here. Look, if you see, if I curve, when I will play, in order to get a sound with flesh, this is, look, this is just flesh. This is flesh and nail, and this isn't pure nail. Then flesh only, look, same action and actually same angle. Look, this is with the flesh and nail, both, and then just nail. It's more superficial. Because why? If I have too long this, then I can play only nail sound, right? So when I will bend the finger to get my posture for pick out like this, right? Then I will count that when I sand the nails. You see, I have less nail than the tip of the flesh of the finger. The ring finger maybe a little bit more. Sometimes people do that. And try to keep the shape of the nail same shape as the shape of the tip of your finger, right? This is one thing that helps. Here, this is the exception because we have in the external part of the thumb less and then more here to be able to get also different tones. Like this will be, if I play more frontal, I will have more nail. Nail sound, you see, perpendicular, as it becomes perpendicular to the top. This one thing. This is nail, most pure nail. Then we have less nail, nail and flesh, more nail and flesh, like this, and more flesh than nail, like this. And then pure flesh. Sided, so that's why the thumb has this shape. So we have more nail here and less here, like this, right? This one is the exception. Can be a little bit same or higher than the flesh here. But with the fingers, you have to be careful to have always less nail than it should not go above the flesh, right? Like this, look. In this case, you can see it very clearly. That they have this one first, and then the nail comes below. So when I get to this posture, same thing happens. I will have first the yema, the tip of the finger, and then I have the nail, and that allows me to have a much rounder sound. So another person asked me also that what happens if one part of the nail, if you are wearing off more one part, say the side of the nail, as opposed to having the right in the center or something, if you wear off a side of the nail while you practice scales or something, it means just like in the shoe, we can examine if we see where we step, how we step. If it is a side step with the shoes, you can analyze how a person step, right? If it is straight or if it is sided, if he's stepping sided, has one part of the shoe wear off more than another. So same thing here, we can examine that and there is no problem much, unless it is really an extreme thing, like going to the edge of the finger, no problem if you have, if you are wearing off a part that is not the central part of the finger. But you have to be careful that your posture is right and that you can play the note straight, right? Straight, so that you can get the best sound. And of course, it may happen that you wear off one part of the nail, but on the sides, I mean, as opposed to having it just perfectly on the tip of the nail. So this is natural, no problem, unless it's an extreme thing. There is no problem with that also. So keep your nails short, because this is very important to do, and develop a nice tone in which you can decide to play with flesh and nail, or just with nail. If you have long the nails, that's not good, because you can sound only naily. So keep those tips in mind, and I see you next time.